Welcome to the STABcast, a podcast dedicated to Star Wars Legion.
Welcome, cadets and commanders, to the STABcast, the Sunsphere Tactical Attack Brigade's Star Wars Legion podcast. You are here just in time for the holiday fun. That's right, everybody. Welcome, gentlemen. Welcome.
How we doing?
I'm fantastic.
Yeah, you started pre-gaming on us.
If you can't hear by the clink of the ice in the glass of the microphone, we have started the imbibing of the holiday season. This is Ben Fowler speaking to you with Ryan Slawoski and Will Heim. We're doing our holiday movie.
Is this the first show we've not done nicknames? Is this the first time?
Yeah. Did we do the last holiday special?
I don't know if the other holiday specials had nicknames.
I'm pretty sure they probably did. You screwed it up, Ben, but that's all right. It's all right.
I mean, listen, we're flying by the seat of the pants here. I just came from the grocery shopping, so I had to fight the crowds to get in there. I had to quickly make my drink. Will has been pre-gaming all day.
All day.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, as a man who will be employed but is not currently employed, he can do that.
Yep.
Indeed.
It's fine. It's a Saturday. You can day drink on a Saturday. There's no judgment.
This is true. Well, remember, we're from the South. There's always judgment in day drinking.
That's fair.
I'm free here.
Now that Will's a Westerner, he can do as he pleases. Mm-hmm. Government be damned.
So, Ben, what the hell are we doing here? Other than dying.
Yeah, sorry. I'm still fighting
back. His spike nog has already killed him.
Yeah, so we are watching what I have been trying to get us to watch for like 2.5 years now.
Yeah, it's been a while. We've resisted, to say the least.
We said we were going to wait till the Ewoks came out, and then you were like, I don't want to do that. That sounds terrible. And then you bought the Ewoks, Ryan, and then you didn't like them. And then Will bought more of the Wookiees, and turns out he loves them. So I was like, we got to do an Ewok Christmas. We got to do the Ewoks.
Yeah, it's
we've
time.
Also run out of
we've run out of other Star Wars content to do. Yeah,
yeah.
There's only so much. We're gonna have to do.
There's only so much down here when you scroll to the bottom of Disney Plus.
Yeah.
So yeah, for those of you who want to listen along, we are watching Caravan of Courage on Disney Plus. We're at the 6-second mark. So when we tell you, count you in, we're going to go 3, 2, 1, go. And then that place you'll press play and you'll be with us watching this beautiful adventure.
Yeah. Let's go through our experience with this show. Cause it is different it's even more different than how our usual Star Wars, accoutrements. Usually Ben's the one who's never seen the thing before. And me and Will are the various guides, but I haven't seen this in 20 years. I remember renting this at Blockbuster Video in New Orleans.
I have never seen this.
Yeah. I was about to say, I'm going to bet Will has never seen this.
Yeah, I've not.
And I've got Ryan beat. I haven't seen this in probably 35 years.
Oh, okay. Okay, so you do have
So when we were overseas, we would get cable, but we didn't get a lot of things. And so this movie was actually my first introduction to Star Wars.
No wonder you like Star Trek more.
Yeah, no wonder you like Star Trek better.
We rented this on base at the PBX inside the little video section. I remember renting this with my dad. We were in Guam at the time, so we didn't have a lot of cable options. I remember having seen this. Now, I do tend to blend this movie and the other movie together because I think at some point they were probably aired back to back.
Yeah,
in some kind of blended fashion on television.
This was my first exposure. Remember this movie, so I'm not gonna be too terribly far away from Will, and especially as we get into this, we are all drinking. Will, you started. What's in the glass? What are we sipping on?
Oh, just orange juice and vodka, a classic.
Okay. The holiday classic of the tropical fruit. Yep.
Listen, oranges are what you get for Christmas. This is
true. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's fair. That's fair.
I decided to go with a single malt, single barrel rye whiskey from Jack Daniel's. Picked it up last Christmas, actually. I've only had a couple sniffs of it since then, so I got my big one ice cube, my nice sipping glass here.
There you go.
Also, went to go pick up some eggnog, but the grocery store had nothing but half gallons of eggnog, which I definitely don't need. What with the diabetes,
crush it
and
crush it, man. We'll pick you up off the floor. It's fine.
Chug.
I would have to go. Yeah, my belly. I'd have to go take a break in the middle of this cast to go use the restroom. So I did find a smaller 1-pint container of a coconut milk nog. I've done a little bit of tasting on it. It's not bad. It's not as thick and creamy as an eggnog is because of the lactose and the egg. But, I mean, it's actually not bad. I could see making some French toast out of this thing tomorrow morning.
All right.
I could. It turned out pretty nice.
So. Now, Ryan, your classical holiday beverage.
Yeah, everyone knows that I'm a bourbon man, but I was at a holiday function earlier this week, and I am currently out of bourbon. So we're just on straight moonshine tonight, boys and girls, and I've got about a third of a pint glass filled, and we'll see how long I make it before I fall over.
It's really a test of endurance here tonight.
The most hill country you could have been was, here's my moonshine.
Yeah.
Well, is it in your mason jar glass?
Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. For sure.
Okay. I mean, of course.
You could always cut it with some tap water.
That sounds like bitch talk to me, sir.
That sounds awful.
Yeah.
So for those of you who have never seen this movie, let me give you the plot summary from Wikipedia.
Oh, we're just going to spoil it, huh?
Yeah, we just got to get from the start, because who only knows where this is headed, all right? Let's just call this.
We may not be able to air the back half of this. We're not sure. Yes, well,
it'll air.
Tim's not
it'll
here to
be...
start shouting slurs, so we should be fine.
Yeah, that's fair. That's fair.
I will say, dear listeners, we tried to get Tim on. Tim's mom is in town right now with him and his wife, and Tim's wife and Tim's mom don't necessarily get along very well, so Tim plays mediator. You can't leave them unsupervised. I was like, Tim, get your mother a headset, put her on microphone.
Yeah, absolutely.
I want to know what Cindy Hannon knows about Star Wars, The Caravan of Courage, and Ewok Adventure.
He declined.
It would have been delightful.
It would have been something.
It would have been a thing, yeah. So, the plot summary. On the forest moon of Endor, the Tawani family star cruiser lies wrecked. The Tawani family, Katarine, Jeremit, Mace, and Kendall, are stranded.
Mace Windu.
When Katarine and Jeremit vanish, having been captured by the Gorax, the children are found by the Ewok Deej. After Mace threatens them, Ewoks subdue him and take both children to the Ewoks' home. There, Kendall and Wicket become friends. Uh-oh. Shortly thereafter, the Ewoks kill a boar wolf, only to find a life model from one of the Tawani parents within the creature.
This isn't a summary. This isn't a stinger. This is like
this
an
is
essay.
The plot.
This is the whole thing.
Yeah, you're not reading.
I'm just getting you started.
Oh God.
I mean, to be fair, this is how Will consumes most films. Is just
this is
I read it on Wikipedia.
Listen, or that's just the inciting incident. This is just Act One of this film.
Jesus.
So yeah. That'll get us started here. Let's get us started here. There's a whole bunch of like low grades in this film. I think that's the first time I ever knew that low grade was mentioned. I know Wicket is in this film.
Mm-hmm.
So I know that's a thing. I know that Kendall, the actress who plays the little girl, may have been 5 years older than all of us. She's tiny, Will. Like, don't be shocked when you see this tiny child. Like, she's tiny. So, like, she's smaller than the actor who walks himself.
Yeah, that's true. I do recall that.
But yeah, you are here for the commentary of Caravan of Courage and Ewok Adventure. Again, I'm going to count us in. 3, 2, 1, go. When I say the word go, you're going to press the play button on your screens at home, listeners.
And then you have to take a drink. Yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
Yep.
Absolutely. I'm just looking at the poster for this film. By the way, delightful poster. That kid definitely looks like a Luke Skywalker photocopy. The Luke Skywalker at home.
Wish.com, Luke Skywalker.
Yep. All right, Will, are you ready?
I am prepared.
Ryan, are you ready?
No, but that's what the moonshine's for.
Yep. Here we go. I'm counting us in. 3, 2, 1, go. So we are at the 6-second mark to get there.
I do miss like the 20th Century Fox fanfare is so intertwined.
I really do.
With like the transition into Star Wars, that the Disney movies with their new cool logo is neat, but it's doesn't have the same pop.
Does not have the same pop.
Oh, do we not get a text crawl?
Mm-mm.
Oh, by the way, Christmas? This is Burl Ives, everybody. Burl Ives.
Glorious shot in 4x3.
Yes. Hey, at least they didn't crop it like The Simpsons.
Oh, this is true.
I'm having to turn up the film.
Definitely a soundstage. We own 12 trees for the shot.
I don't know. Somewhere in the mists of California, it could be.
That's true. This could have been shot nearby where they did E.T.
Was Endor just North California, or was it actually a soundstage for all those trees?
Bit of column B.
Okay. I mean, obviously, like, the bunker was a set. Well, our children are dead.
If we point these flashlights straight at the camera, you can't see how bad this movie is.
They applied a nice film grain effect to the film.
No, that's just old, Will. That's just old.
That's actual, actual film grain.
When in a dangerous biome with unknown alien creatures in the middle of the night, shouting is often a great survival tactic.
I think between the fog and the flashlights, you're right. I think it's just to obscure the fact this is a soundstage.
Yeah, 100%.
Our child's jacket.
It's also padded and quilted like our own.
That's because it's from space, Ben.
We gotta stay warm in space.
Everything is these quilted space in space.
Attack of the Muppets.
That's a big old Muppet.
You know, I think I met him at a GWAR show once.
You would go to a GWAR show.
Yeah, he would. Ooh, an Ewok Adventure subtitle.
What so a beautiful nice painting. Yes.
Warwick Davis, second billing, good for him, has probably zero actual dialogue.
Yeah, I think his dialogue was all done by somebody else. Ooh, production design got in there before the director. Like, this is how when we talk about the Wookiee village, Ewok villages, like, I remember this more than I remember that third Star Wars film. Because I was born in late 81, so I didn't see any of this in theaters.
That's called the trauma has burned it into your mind.
Yeah.
Like, this is my first recollection of that. Like, I probably didn't see the actual films till the 90s, where I had seen this long before that. Like, 86, 87.
So is this before or after the, you know, weapon of mass destruction is built by slave labor in their sky?
I believe before, but who knows?
I believe this is a prequel.
Oh, lovely.
Oh, look. An Ewok pony.
I think that's just a pony.
The teeth are terrifying.
Deej nuts.
If only... Oh,
it is the Burl Ives is really making this a holiday flair. Like, I just want to keep hearing...
The unblinking, unwavering eyes.
That kid can't get off that swing.
There's not enough movement walk in this it costume.
Off. Walk it off. Also, is that a baby doll or just a baby Ewok?
Probably both. Both can be true.
The Ewoks themselves have soulless, unblinking eyes, so you that's can't really true. Tell.
I love how infant... there's no subtitles and there is no English.
The infant did not have a wrapping before...
To be fair, that's like one of the cool things about Star Wars, though, is we don't get, like, R2 or Chewbacca subtitles.
Into the sunlight, where a hawk can swoop down on him.
Based on that thing we just saw.
Their yeah.
Oh, God.
All right, that looks like Southern California.
Yeah, that's 100% California.
Oh, yeah. Deej nuts. I can't stop.
Glad we have crude tools, yet have mastered flight. Fire, blunt weapons, flying.
Is that
there? We did the tech tree, boys.
You want goats?
Oh, those goats!
Everything's pygmy here. Does Endor just have high gravity? Is that why everything's small?
Well, except there was that giant thing earlier. So,
it's perspective. It's just perspective.
Really, I think it was 30 feet tall.
How many of these Ewok actors were headbutted by these goats from behind? At least five, right?
We only got one take where a goat didn't fuck him up.
Everything was just two takes, and you had to use the best of what you had.
Mm-hmm.
I did not pour enough moonshine for this.
Ryan is already out of drink. It's been 5 minutes.
God, it's the teeth, man.
Oh, Jesus. Oh,
remember, they eat... Oh, no, that seems bad.
Oh, dear.
And goat launch. Whee!
See, this is what we need in Legion, and I'll play Bright Tree.
That's just a normal hang glider.
Yes. Yes. I'm kind of surprised we didn't get a hang glider with the Ewok release.
Not yet. Really, we'll get one.
I want to say go back in the Wayback Machine and like when it was still under FFG and they first showed the minis, I swear there was a glider.
I thought there was a catapult. Sure
I'm sure it's been scrubbed from the internet at this point.
Yeah. Just like most of FFG.
Oh, so sad. How did the spaceship crash and not move any trees?
It was very small.
But see, now we got the missing children of the Tawani family and the missing children of Deej ties these two storylines together.
Is that what's happening?
It's a writing masterclass, guys. A writing masterclass.
That was two adult people.
Wearing these tiny rugs.
And also, they don't know how to transition, so the camera just pans wildly.
Yep.
Which is weird, because this is all like green screen background stuff.
We don't have a cutaway. Just pan left.
Just show some rocks.
So is this glider just going to airlift them out? Oh, no, he just threw the rope down.
He just gave him a rope. I can shimmy on down.
But how do they get up there?
Yeah.
They're like mountain goats. They can climb like 87-degree angles.
So this is where my brain blends things together. Was there actually a glider in Return of the Jedi?
No.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, no, there was. Yeah, there was. They drop rocks.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, that's right. They do drop the rocks. Okay.
Yeah, see, my brain transcribes
all of those things to this.
Yeah. Yeah, this is Ben's Return of the Jedi.
Yes. In the same way that my episode 2 was actually mostly episode 3.
Oh, no.
Oh, those were two actors.
He's dead.
Who just died.
And now I've landed the glider, so now we have no way to get back home.
We landed it off screen? Okay.
You just call them idiots?
I think that was a Nazi salute.
Oh no, it's the Aryan Ewoks.
Is he riding an imaginary horse?
He's probably just constipated.
He's like slapping his own thigh.
What, you never played slap ass with yourself?
I mean, it is Saturday night with a lot of alcohol.
Alright, so now we find it.
We will worship it as our god.
So how has the internet not made this Star Cruiser some kind of model that people secretly lust after?
I mean, sure someone has.
I'm going to go look for a 3D print.
Sorry, they'll when they do the re-release, they'll digitally enhance that just to be a crash sheathapede.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yep.
Marketing, everything's got a tie back.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you can find Mace Tawani's blaster in a 3D print.
There you go.
Can't find the Star Cruiser, though, but I'm trying.
I will say, there's some solid greebling in this wreck. Like it?
There is. Yeah. Oh, yes. Hold on. This took at least an afternoon.
Yeah.
Now, granted, they probably just had some garbage laying behind the set, or the soundstage.
Wait. How do these children not shout when their mother came to go shout for them?
Maybe they maybe it's time travel.
Maybe they came back to this ship after their parents were eaten.
Is this a flashback? Stab the kid. Stab him.
This one is tiny. We will not be able to bake it. I will have to make some kind of stew. I do love how 80s this is between the mom's haircut and this girl's
wig.
Purple but light white and yeah. Oh, those curls? Like that's absolutely perm.
That's true. Pet the child, yes.
Is that a fang fighter?
No.
You can try there, buddy. Good try. It's probably from a different sci-fi franchise, and they just smashed it up. Oh, that is not how you properly handle a firearm, sir.
Do you see what I said? He looks exactly like a Wish.com Luke Skywalker.
He really does. All friends. They're space hillbillies.
I told you. She's smaller than the other Ewoks. Dog paw the child. Dog paw the child.
And then they ate him.
This one is large enough to roast.
You just got your ass kicked by three Ewoks.
I mean, they're resilient little buggers.
Yeah.
I mean, if it takes a try.
They put a...
tied him to two poles.
Space llamas?
Feed him to that space alpaca. Some strong backlight.
See, this really breaks my immersion when they've got tents on the ground. This is supposed to be a tree house.
This is where the poor Ewoks live, on the ground.
Oh, that's true. This is actually a film about class.
It's about gentrification of Bright Tree Village.
You're actually opening a craft brewery.
You there, dirty child. Come here. Those unblinking eyes.
They're terrible. I'm going to see these tonight in my sleep.
And we dropped him. Mother Ewok.
We have discovered the need for clothes making and hoods, yet we see no value in pants.
By the way, according to the wiki, all their last names are Warwick.
Oh, yeah, that's
like
fair.
Wicket Warwick and...
That's probably just like, you know, their...
Weechie Warwick.
Their galactic given name where they need a surname, so it's just what we call them.
Their government name?
Yeah. I'll take this blanket, be warm, while we sacrifice your brother to our dark gods. This is how we learn linguistics with Star Wars.
Do I have food? I have this hatchet.
You need these hands. Our diet does not consist of rocks.
Oh, she's going to die of the consumption. This is where a child normally vomits, by the way.
Yeah, that's fair.
Yep.
Also, if we look at their little stump coffee table, we have candles. Hang gliders and candles have been made. But not pants. Not pants.
But they're wearing fur. Like, do they need pants?
Then why the hoods?
Chewbacca doesn't wear pants.
That's fine. That's He also doesn't wear a hood. Like, all of his clothing is utility.
Maybe it rains a lot.
For rain? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's rain.
How'd they get a shell?
All right, you need this sushi. Actually, it's more of like a grape leaf. It's more like Greek food.
It's a leaf.
It's how they get you into their multi-level marketing scheme.
Oh, Gunda. Gunda. You tell it's real hot in there because they're all sweating. You missed her mouth, sir.
Yeah. You know,
like it's not a very big mouth, but you missed. Like, it's all down her chin. At least the eyebrows, when you film from above, at least hide some of the unblinking eye.
But those teeth in the background.
The teeth, man.
I do love how
she's
this is
dead.
Like the third take of that shot, because that medicine's all on her cheek.
Yeah, for sure. Take two is we need you guys to smear it more.
Yeah. This could be the film stock. They're all just a background of brown. Like all those movies are all just brown. Tiny pony. That one's slightly more blonde.
We've got a color balance again.
This film funded the entire, like, pygmy population of animals for California for probably 3 years.
Oh.
Or did they just use force perspective before Peter Jackson could?
Probably.
This film probably is not innovative.
Listen, how did we never get Ewok wrestling as some bigger part of Star Wars?
Well, that's just done. Oh, oh, dear. Wicket's
bringing the moves.
Is that Wicket?
I think it is Wicket, yes. As played by Warwick Davis. But his voice by Daryl Enrique.
Well, thank you for clarifying.
Enriquez? Enriquez, sorry. It's spelled Enrique, but then it's apparently spelled differently here.
I've exhausted my first beverage and have risen.
Oh, God. Will, we're not that far into the film.
It's okay. I have more.
We're 17 minutes in.
I'm now drinking a Simply Spiked Peach.
Ooh.
Wherever you're listening, be sure to put in the comments which one of us you think will pass out first. It's not Ben.
But, oh, no. I'm much more.
He doesn't drink aggressively enough.
The only time this happened, it was when Will was the one plying me with drinks. And then he got me wasted.
I've tried.
I nearly killed you. It's true.
In this economy? Oh, are we going to sacrifice our rabbit?
That's a dinner. What do we look like? A pharmacy? Part of hunter-gatherer society, don't you understand, little child?
Your sister is weak and shall die.
We have what we need. We don't really have preservatives yet.
I was saving this medicine for our baby.
For that, we have to research metallurgy.
She looks both 5 years old and 80 years old at the same time.
You tell me she's got Clint Howard syndrome from Star Trek?
I'm pretty sure that's the same can be said about you without a beard, Will.
Yeah.
This is true.
The less that's said about any of us without a beard is the better, though.
I did show Will's lady friend a picture of me with no beard, and it drew many shocked conversations.
It was truly horrifying.
No, it was me beardless and no hair on top, so it was a...
Right, you were just an egg.
It was aerodynamic mode.
And no glasses, so my eyes were gigantic.
Back when you were a cyclist, yes.
Bravo on walking through this forest like that.
Can't see shit in this thing.
Behind these unblinking eyes.
I wish you want to tap this maple tree. Oh, maple syrup is the fruit of life.
Turns out this was Space Canada all along.
Uh-oh, that's a puppet in a tree. Puppet in a tree. Oh, but this is Star Wars. That's probably like an animal on the tongue of a bigger animal that's going to eat this kid through that tree.
Yeah, and there's probably four puppeteers inside the tree.
Don't worry, he's got a TV remote on his back.
Oh, man, the grain of this is pretty bad.
That is a Muppet. Is this just a direct VHS rip?
That's what this feels like.
And that's, boys and girls, where Furbies come from.
Why would you just stick your arm into a tree? I mean, Tim did that one time at that truck stop, but...
Yeah, but he paid for that, and he knew he was getting into.
We'll have to chop off your arm.
Oh.
You were correct. It's the old tree lizard.
But luckily just gummed him, so...
Yeah.
Unlike the Ewoks, it had no teeth.
Gotta keep that PG, you know.
Meanwhile, she's dying.
We can survive a plane crash.
Oh, that's on fire.
We gotta burn the alcohol out.
First you put in the Sambuca, then you light it on fire. And here's our distilled maple syrup.
Burned maple syrup.
This would be filmed in Vancouver now.
or an Eastern European country.
Oh, that's true.
Does that I'm say going to see Malone that County? In my dreams. Now there's a tongue, and I think I hate it.
Oh, no.
Oh, put some sparklers in there.
Pop, throw pop. Some pop rocks at it.
And then we use this leaf as a spoon.
Once again, the tech tree seems real strange here.
They have what they need.
Yeah,
spoons. I'm maybe spoons seem pretty cool.
Have you ever tried a leaf spoon?
No. Fair point.
Okay.
Oh. Seeing the human lips behind the Ewok lips are kind of disturbing too.
Yeah.
Like Mama Warwick's mouth didn't move enough. Like it was a. The mask didn't go with him. That also wasn't the arm that was eaten.
That's true. He just got a rash.
Also, I love how she's perfectly okay with whatever prison break tracking bracelet he's got wearing.
Yeah.
That's just style. Fashion.
Definitely a small alpaca.
You see, Mace, your sister has Ewok smallpox.
Oh.
Ferrets.
That's they're just a normal ferret. Oh, yeah, they're awful creatures.
Man. Between this and Willow, ferrets were all over the 80s.
As someone who had one in the 90s, can confirm. I would like to own you? Is that what she just said?
That's exactly what that sounds like to me. That was the excuse every white person's ever used in a colonized country.
Well, we just kind of showed up here.
You want me to do the worm? I can also do the worm. If this Ewok just started dancing a Star Cruiser dance right now, I wouldn't be shocked or surprised. Bunk.
He just punches the ferret.
Yeah, that's exactly what that looked like to me.
That's probably what it deserves. Oh. Never film with real animals.
Oh, that ferret's inside that costume now.
I mean, yep. The two things they always say never to bring on set are children and animals. And,
you know, we have both. Yeah. Oh, have that both ferret's not happy.
Children acting as animals. Oh, see? Another Christmas holiday special. That's Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer right there.
He doesn't have a red nose, Ben.
He has a green nose.
He has a green nose. Remember, it is indoor. It would be a different nose color.
Stop licking your lips. I'm sure they study this
ferret on screen quite a bit.
Yeah.
I'm sure all they study this at the USC film school.
Treats in their sleeves.
Like, this Ewok's gotten more screen time than Leia did in those last three films.
Well, now they've got the correct sleeve ripped up.
This is true. God, that tongue. It's that tongue just sticking out.
Put it away.
I don't know.
Why does Warwick Davis keep acting? Also, where did that full suit come from?
It was under his vest.
I guess it was, yeah.
Yeah, he was wearing an orange jumpsuit and took the vest off.
It just feels like he reversed it. Like
walking hairbrushes.
Yes, they're animals. The guys with candles and medicine from trees.
And a society.
Oh, the stop motion.
Ooh. I do love some classic stop motion.
Why are those stop motion pheasants running across the screen?
Did Bambi's mom die?
Oh,
We can close their eyes when they sleep, but we still have to see the teeth.
Oh. Baby is horrifying.
His blood pressure is out of control.
The scrotum child. And the hairy chickens.
Yep. Very hairy chicken. Where are you running to, son?
We'll simply go into the forest of death.
Yep.
Rather than stay in this home.
Let's sneak him out into the darkness. I'm too weak to move. You see, like me, like she's tiny. She can't be more than 5 or 6 years old here.
Yeah.
Man, look at those 90 space boots.
Yeah, you gotta put the space boots. 80 space boots. Steal their produce after they've shown you all the kindness.
Yep.
I love how his vest fits like Snap Wesley's vest.
You and the Snap Wexley again. He died in Rise of Skywalker. Weren't you happy?
It was the one time I cheered in that film.
Sorry I didn't make it in film to put you in my movies, Ben.
Listen,
that's why you hate him.
Is my jealousy of Greg Grunberg because he's in all the sci-fi things I enjoy? Perhaps. Is he in them only because his buddy got famous? Also, perhaps.
So you don't seem to hate all of Adam Sandler's friends that he hires for all of his movies.
Yeah, but I'm not jealous.
We don't watch
of that.
Those movies.
That's true.
I mean,
that's true.
Don't get me wrong. Would it be nice if Ryan were to become film famous and take us all on vacations once a year to do films? Sure. That'd be nice. It'd be handy. Do we get to hang out with Salma Hayek because he's on Famous? Maybe. You know, I'd do it.
Almost where?
We're clearly filming day for night, so. Also, I'm also out of my drink. What did this film do to me? Uh-huh. Like, I had 3 fingers of whiskey. I don't know where it is now.
I believe it's inside of you.
I'm down to 3 fingers.
Oh, Jesus. No, I'm glad.
It's been a day.
I feel like it's been longer than that. That was
me just use my handy dandy fire starter.
It was a fire starter, right? It really was. Oh, he was a bad
son. So my rebellious teen angst is to crash our spaceship.
It's because his last words to his dad were, I hate you.
Yeah, I only hate now you, at father. The brink of death, I realize I, in fact, was the asshole.
Maturity.
Reddit agrees. Oh, man. Sorry. Yeah. I see that vest again. I'm thinking that was Dash Rendar. Like, this is who Dash Rendar became.
This is Oscar-worthy right now.
I really regret crashing that spaceship full of a bunch of other civilians. In an act of rebellion against my family?
I will protect you. Oh, excuse me? No.
Sounds like you need to go see someone professional, sir.
Uh-oh. Big beast?
It's the budget monster.
It has terrifying feet.
It's all about tension and day for night, because that's clearly daylight in the background.
Smokey would be very disappointed that they left.
Oh, that's
fire.
A rodent of unusual size. Did that rodent just deflect?
I'm glad this 12-year-old found a gun. He seems really quite proficient with it.
Yeah, clearly.
Listen, the last time I went into a tree stump did not end well for us. Oh, when he left the weapon outside.
Hmm.
Oh, that's a big meaty claw.
Big meaty claws. Scream more, children.
I love that it also has an opposable thumb.
The script is just 3 pages of just, like, parentheses screaming.
Also, Ewoks only have 3 fingers, but that one definitely had 5.
What? That's... Are you saying that's an Ewok? Is everything here an Ewok? Are we all Ewoks? No,
I'm just saying, you know, most mammals have some variations of, you know, 4s and 5s.
Ewok-based evolution.
They've been, you know, formed together. That's what I'm saying. Clearly divergent evolutionary lines of this planet. Did that Ewok just ass into this tree?
Yep,
he sure did.
They dared him to do it. It's a rite of passage.
Oh, man, if this monster just ate a whole bunch of
Ewoks. Just annihilated the family.
By the way, this is how we all fought the boars back in, you know, the 500s.
We would... You know that someone would have some kind of ranged projectile.
Yeah, I don't know if their slingshots would be working.
They have slings, yeah.
Yeah, but in Legion they don't throw crits. That guy's clearly got armor 1. Where is that model, my Legion? Or my Imperial Assault? Oh, he... All right. Nothing like a little Ahabin. They call me Low Gray.
Oh, we're engaged in chemical warfare now.
Ah. Well, why didn't you use the tranquilizer from the start?
Yeah. Yes, but you'd accidentally.
Oh, Jesus. It's dead.
What kind of pharmacology?
And that's when Wicket used the nerve agent.
Good old Ewok poison.
A little
Many
DX
of Wicket's opponents have been known to fall out of the 7-story windows when they question the Bright Tree government.
Oh. Why is it? Okay.
Sorry. I should imagine Putin hiring Wicket. Where all the Russians have died over the last 20 years. Just Wicket out there. This is an odd mix of polonium. This must be Wicket.
The village shall eat for a year off this carcass. As it steams from the inside because someone had a smoke machine and they thought it'd be cool.
Its blood is so hot, Ryan, and the air so cool.
You see, child, this is death.
Oh, see, the Wikipedia lied to me. They told me that that chain was inside the animal. Yeah, why is it tied to the beast?
Thang.
It's Chekhov's werepig.
Thanks, Burlives, for giving us the plot.
Oh, more ferret.
Oh. Man, those chickens. The jerky.
It's monitoring his life from afar?
I think so. I think that's the mom's bracelet, which has, you know, like the Go Find My Kids app.
Inside of a giant monster?
Being digested.
It's attached to the collar. It's attached to the collar of the giant monster.
No, but they're talking about the fourth one, like where the other one is. Oh. Like,
yeah, where's...
Your parents got 8, bro.
Like, where's mom's monitor?
By the way, I love how these kids are doing absolutely no chores here. Just freeloading white kids.
I mean.
Try speaking slowly. That'll help.
And louder.
Yes, our technological fury is mostly hangar glider fights and, you know, candles, but. Pantomime. Oh.
Hey, Low Gray.
He's going to give you a shit ton of surge tokens.
Yeah.
And drugs.
And an owl?
Low gray is
an owl. Gargling Listerine is my new favorite thing about this movie.
Excuse me.
Hey, look, we've upgraded to lanterns. Also, remember, the Welsh do have a history of putting animal skulls on their heads and then walking around asking riddles of each other for Christmas.
Are they
Druids? I may get us in trouble for this. Is this a Star Wars dreidel? Are they implying things here?
It seems to be a lantern dreidel.
Oh, no, it's a lantern dreidel. Yeah, there it goes. It's spinning now. It's spinning.
Low-grade's maybe costume it's a bad got a real downgrade.
Yeah, it did. Which is
the
weird.
The only way we can express emotions in these costumes is the angle of the eyebrow.
And our fingers. Oh.
Oh.
Stare into the flashing lights.
Epilepsy, mysticism, same thing, really.
Honestly, yeah. There's been some people who said that. Oh,
oh no. We're having a spiritual moment. Oh no. Don't stare so intently.
That's my dad.
The secret ingredients was LSD all along.
Listen, just a little peyote in the smoke. It's fine. I don't know what's sadder. Is that I have more gray and white in my
their
beard?
Souls.
Oh, is that a gremlin? Is that a...
Just shout louder, kid. Shout louder. Well, that's the way of the force, kid.
Yeah, Lil Gray's like, they're already dead. Sorry. Nothing we can do about that.
He's very cross-eyed.
I do like how we just add
when you
look
into the
girl.
Future, maybe you'd be cross-eyed, too.
Oh, I'm about to be cross-eyed. These nuts.
These nuts? Cleveland.
It would be Ohio.
It would be.
So they're dead, right? Oh yeah.
They're dead.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Nothing we can do about it, kid. They're dead. God.
Ja, man.
Is watching his tongue push the teeth forward.
Yeah, the fake teeth around, yeah.
We declare war on the Gorgax. Sorry, Gorgax.
Race war, race war.
No will.
It's a pretty good Zim impression.
It's pretty good. We're only declaring war against the one, the Gorax, not against all Goraxes. What is with these people sneaking out in the middle of the night? You live in a forest planet filled of larger prime, you know.
You'd think the Ewoks would have been hunted to extinction by the larger predators by now.
No, I mean, that's human evolution, too.
They are the apex predators here. Let's be real. They've got tools.
They have tools and they group together. I mean, yeah.
Yeah.
I guess the Gorax we saw kind of had some accoutrements as well.
He had an axe.
Hey, look, it's your kid that you'll never see again.
Oh, this is exactly what's going to happen. He's going to die in this battle. I actually don't know if that's true or not, but I just...
Yeah, no, that's... I mean, it has to.
Yeah.
Oh, the poor sphincter baby. Again. Why is its mouth keep doing that?
They took it into the design studio and just like, just make the cheeks chubbier. Just make them chubbier. Just keep going. Dial it up to 13.
I think the mom is called Weechi, maybe.
Or maybe can we make the baby more of a ball sack?
A big furry ball sack.
Oh, We've tricked these nice people into fighting for us.
Also sounds like some British. Interesting. Yeah,
white colonialism at its finest.
Ready our war ponies.
These rocks? Easter eggs that we buried underground for 3 days to make it look dirty.
Wow, there's a whole hut on the horse.
Because it's a full-size horse, it can support that.
Uh-huh.
Look at me, not Luke Skywalkering. Everybody, listen to me.
I will give you gather around. Dodge tokens.
What?
Take a knee. Take a knee, everybody. I'm sending most of you to your death.
These are the tools you may use.
Ooh. I'd play that video game, The Legendary Ewok Warriors.
It's an anime coming this fall.
Live action by Netflix in 5 years.
Yeah.
Ooh, the feather crown. Oh, Weechi's the eldest son. Nope.
Beat his ass.
You do not get the magic stick. You get the rock. That is all we trust you with. This rock of beatdown.
It's all right. It's Chekhov's rock.
What?
Well, we needed an axe, too.
Yeah, it's really what this boils down to.
Oh,
in the hero's journey, we have to encounter more Ewoks, which then test us.
We need something in the middle to test us, exactly.
Listeners, there's 50 minutes of this left. You are not halfway done.
Yo, we are not halfway done.
It feels like it's been 2 hours. Like,
my drink is halfway done.
How many Ewok actors died trying to get down this ladder?
37.
I'm on my third like, spike peach. We're
but
doing
yet,
good.
Oh, but yet she gets the basket.
Yeah.
Well, yes, she's small.
Yeah, those others are actually just adult actors in costumes, so they're allowed to die. I say that having played The Wizard of Oz, and they put me in a lift without any of the safety materials, so they lift me off stage, and it was all for insurance purposes. Like, I could play The Wiz and die, and be fine.
He threw the rock.
He discarded the rock of legendary power.
Well, she's good thing Wicket's there to get it. See, now I know their name is based on their special tools. Wicket has the stick.
Also, why is no one painted their Red Wings of Courage on one of their models?
I don't think anyone knew about
this movie in 30 years.
This movie came out officially November 25th, 1984. I was 3 years old.
So it's almost 40 years old, huh?
Yep. Damn it, you're right. We should have waited till next year to do the 40th anniversary.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to have a big celebration like they did for Empire Strikes Back.
Nope, probably not.
Just a hunch.
You get to walk, bitch. You threw the rock away.
That's, oh. You're a baby. Get in the hut.
Then walk, bitch.
Chief you see, Sherpa Peter Jackson ass. Stole from this scene in order to make The Lord of the Rings. This is all Galadriel and the elves and the rope for Frodo and Sam. And
you know, I was just about to say that.
The white hand of Sherpa.
And see, in a second, they're going to reach down and say to Warwick, which way do I go, Warwick? I do not know. And then Warwick will be like, to the left. That poor mummified baby is just horrified.
I'm glad we are sending our best warriors to go and die on a suicidal mission for these two strangers.
Good luck, everybody.
Let me hold Warwick Davis on this horse so he doesn't fall off in this costume.
So, this movie, by the way, doesn't feel like a Legion scene, but definitely a Shatterpoint scene. One of the Ewok Shatterpoint models coming. Small squad base skirmishing.
They did just announce the Ewoks for Shatterpoint. You get, like, you get two Ewoks per base.
Ooh.
And then you get Low Gray Wicket R2 and 3PO.
So anytime you see a root system like that, that's normally used to be a swamp. So at some point, the water was higher than that.
So what you're saying is the Ewoks did what all of politicians couldn't, and they drained the swamp?
Jesus.
Yes.
They found the true cure to governmental corruption is a primitive society.
Where'd he get an axe?
They have more advanced technology. They just opt not to use it for knowing what it will bring.
Oh, those trees are a trap.
Well, yep, look. They knew. Oh, did you not hear it at all?
What? What's this?
This is our first Ewok. We must convert.
That's right.
Oh, so it's more like the Wizard of Oz then. Welcome the Tin Man.
I have your nose, the sacred ritual.
I will say that Ewok is just about as tall as that boy.
Well, he's the big, strong Ewok.
He's the swole walk, yeah.
He's the barbarian.
As they pay tribute.
Take the tooth.
Oh.
Well, that was easy.
There we go. Oh, it matches up.
You have to pay the troll toll if you want to know the rest.
There is a boy.
I will take the boy instead. Ooh, chicken? That guy's carrying an actual stone axe. Is that an axe made out of an X-Wing?
They must have made that in a deleted scene.
Yep.
Yeah. We'll watch the specials after this.
Yeah, where's the director's cut?
Is he going to split that axe? Please split that axe. Please split that axe.
Robin Hood it. Yeah. Well, by rights, the boy belongs to me now.
I shall take him as my youthful lover.
They're just giving teeth out like candy.
Oh, see, if you make him beg for it. There you go.
Wow, let me show my token of my appreciation by this token this other guy just gave me. You know, when you re-gift something, you're really supposed to wait a couple months or a year.
The woodsman walk.
The woodsman walk.
Now we're friends. Ha ha ha.
I mean, we need our axe walks with him to bring that pierce damage, yo.
Yep.
He adds that red dye.
We're just marching along. That is a big ass Ewok.
Like he is. He is gigantic. That's a grown ass man.
But somehow smaller than all the Wookiee actors. So. By the way, could you imagine if they actually had the costume money to make all these Wookiees like they'd originally planned? This movie would be very different if these
Star Wars night at your like tier 3 local basketball team would be fucking wild.
This is a light bulb.
This is the crystal where we make the meth.
Yeah, I'm sure your parents are fine. We have to recruit another Ewok.
How many rings did we steal here? That's the light of Galadriel. That's the file.
No, the light of Galadriel is the candle of true light that the child holds.
Yeah, yeah.
Which I'm sure will matter in the dark caves of the whatever it is.
Oh, that looks like a wizard to me.
Me.
Will and I once disturbed a wizard out of his sleep like that.
Go back and listen to a previous bonus episode to hear all about it.
It's only 5 years ago. 6 years ago.
Can you answer these riddles three? Kank.
Kank. Priestess.
Oh, magic test.
Blink three times.
What's the airspeed of an unladen swallow?
No Ewok has ever succeeded before.
Sacrifice your sister.
Oh, she's going to
spit this can of expired cheese whiz.
All of it, including the propellant.
When you just shove this scepter right up your... Oh. It's an iguana.
You are a snake, boy.
Beat him with your stick.
Like, this is actual magic. Like, even lightsaber users, okay, the Jedi theoretically have enhanced abilities. You know, I could put it up to drugs.
Is this the witch you were referring to, Ben?
I don't think so.
Oh, now it's an albino.
Oh, there may be a witch in the next
one. Kill it like the rest. Hank?
No, Kank.
I'm okay with Hank.
I like Hank the Priestess.
Where is this model for Legion, everybody? Ooh.
So we've got the warrior.
What a lovely painting.
We've got the rogue. We just recruited the cleric.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, we're in the rolling hills of Endor.
Gondor calls for aid.
Man, if Aeron showed up right now with horses.
That better not have been your special rock, boy.
No, Wicket's got that, remember? He doesn't believe in the power of magic and friendship.
Are they playing field hockey back behind
you? Yeah, they're playing some sort of sport.
If he gets attacked by another lake animal, a crocodile. Oop.
His reflection stayed.
And thus, lacrosse was invented in Star Wars.
Is he using the special walking stick?
Yes.
Listen, I wouldn't be sad if Mace actually dies right here. I'm just going to be honest. He's would won you? Me no love. He's won me no love.
Oh, we'll get the giant one.
I don't know. I'm on Team Lumberjack here.
All the Team Lumberjack has to do is just break through the ice. Just jump right in. Whoop. And it all got magicked away.
Throw the iguana / mouse / crystal at it.
The rope didn't work, but we're going to try this giant stick.
Apparently he can hold his breath really long. As we all have to pantomime this, trying to figure out how to help.
Destroy our magical artifacts.
Yes.
You see, this is the pool of wicked sinners.
You were gifted the magic stick from the GM.
And he lets go of the funny. Stick while still in the water and is cleaved in half.
I actually thought he just disappeared back down on it again.
Quickly, have the adult man help him. Lumberjack Ewok is just yoked.
Although this movie is 97 minutes long, I've already gotten through all of my drink and all of the eggnog.
I am far too deep into this moonshine that I care to admit.
I have finished my screwdriver and one can of Simply Spiked Strawberry, and now I am having a Simply Spiked Strawberry Peach.
Very nice.
Peach strawberry.
Are they just gambling?
I think they are gambling. And that guy's just like, I'm high as a cat right here.
Oh, we have a map, sure. By the way.
I'm pretty sure that map is also directly from Lord of the Rings. Like, that looks like the map.
No,
to
I'm
the
pretty
Loma
sure that's
Mountain.
A link to the past.
Get inside the horse hut. Thanks, Wicked, you moron. Oh, that guy nearly fell down trying to ride that.
Man, he just yeeted himself onto that horse. That's the equivalent of a human having like a 9-foot vertical.
They just drop all the food? Did we miss the name of the lumberjack?
No, Swole Walk, I think, is all we got.
Okay. I think the wiki gives me a name of Chunka Truck. Or Chukka. Chukka Truck.
Pretty sure you can watch this type of pony race at the county fair.
If this Swole Rock just pulled a Legolas and drops under and then over on that horse's neck. Oh, that was a real poor transition.
There's been good ones?
All right. I'll give you that.
Keep the axe away from your balls,
glad
son.
I did nothing to help save my sister's life.
Yay!
I will say the theme music is working pretty well, actually. I mean, I get that a lot of it's based on John Williams, but still.
I feel like the Swole Walk has solved the two trials so far.
Yes, for sure.
Or at least tried. He's been the one trying the hardest, and he just met them yesterday.
He's been the most active. Thanks, Boy Orange. I also can see the giant-ass mountain in the distance.
Now, so where's the ocean with the Death Star parts that we have to use the special knife to find?
Pretty sure you could buy that tent from Sears Roebuck. Although there's a giant.
I hate to break it to you because you still think you work at Kmart, but that company's not around anymore.
I'm saying you could in 1984.
Oh, Jesus.
Back in my day,
we used a paper catalog. Are you using your special candle for just nightlight?
That's exactly what it looks like. If he falls asleep into this fire.
Then it'll be what he deserves. As an irredeemable pseudo-protagonist.
Oh, fairies?
So he's going to steal your shadow.
Don't go into the lights, hobbitses.
Yeah. Don't answer the fake creatures' questions.
How many different creatures have a claim on his soul at this rate?
All of them.
Also, is this the only movie where the biodiversity of a planet in Star Wars is actually pretty diverse?
Yeah, we've had forests and hills. That's way more than most planets in Star Wars.
We've got multiple varieties of animals with different fingerprints and thumbs.
I mean, most of them are just earth animals, but yes.
But yes, I mean, oh, that's true. Where's the ferret?
I think they left the ferret at home to watch the homestead.
By himself, just a ferret in tiny armor, walking patrol.
Well, those horses can act. They reacted.
Yeah, that's true. Better than Mace Gang. Convincing
performance we've seen this afternoon.
Best actor goes to the horse.
I don't know, Swole Rock has shown some concern despite not being able to blink. So.
None of them have been able to blink, man. That's the problem.
Oh, this is the standards we're at now. Oh, no. He's brought the curse upon us again.
Yep.
It's like, what the fuck? I'm trying to sleep.
He failed his reflex saving throw and has cast fairy fire.
Hank, come help.
See? look at how much Swole Rock is acting right here.
He's really swinging those arms.
What was the direction for this scene? Just flail.
Yes.
I mean, flail. Yes.
We need Hank.
Meanwhile, the cleric is like, I was asleep. You woke me for this?
That's not the cleric. That's just...
Oh, that's right. That's not...
No, that's the cleric back there with the pointy hat.
He's got the pointy hat that is suspiciously like a KKK hood.
But it's got a feather on top. That's... Well, this,
that's true. That's,
this remember, Ewok's
the
just
clan
not...
stole that from the wizards in the first place.
That's fair. That's fair.
Yeah, it was a druid thing first. Yes.
Speaking of full body robes, the cleric does have full body. Full...
Child.
Bring your magic candle.
Bring the magic candle, our most precious invention. Fire.
If this pulls some kind of Harry Potter and absorb all the fairies.
Just the pan with the cleric slowly turning. That was a majestic shot.
Are they all just going to burn themselves on the candle?
Like moths to a flame.
Well, let me just take this into the dull, dry grass we've got spread out here. Sending a candle down into hay has never been a problem.
The cast of Caravan of Courage was consumed by fire today.
Ah, well, we have a backup child, and they're just in costume, so...
That's true. No, all no child actors are actually twins.
Oh, dear.
They're going to form a hurricane. A tornado of fairies.
Pretty sure that's a festival downtown every year.
So what threat did the fairies actually pose?
The fairies have been sucked.
They, someone on the Pixar computer found out a cool thing they could do and they really wanted to put it in the movie.
It has a frowny face.
Oh, that's a Ralph Bakshi cartoon if I've ever seen one.
Mr. Game & Watch?
Oh, last time we saw this on the holiday special, it was mostly just Wookiee pornography.
Yes.
You see? This is exactly what happened the last time.
Better throw her into the candle.
Oh, this is like Ghostbusters? Is that candle gonna get turned off and unleash all the people?
Just like every other semi-intelligent species we've come across as the white man trying to subjugate it.
I mean, you're not wrong.
Okay.
And on. I don't know what that scene
was. We'll save this plot point for later.
Well, we had to get to 90 minutes. That's definitely part of it.
Did we have to?
I'm sure somebody literally found out how to do a cool thing with the computer. I'm like, hey, we got to put this in the movie.
Turns out we don't have enough story.
Oh, do we not?
Not to get to the 90-minute mark.
Oh, it's only been an hour.
There's a...
You gonna retry that one?
Can we get a second?
Get another take here?
I have a secret bag of edibles.
Hell yeah,
enjoy
brother!
Enjoy this oyster cracker.
It's laced.
You won't be hungry when we're done. A handful, dear God, man.
Being hungry is the least of your problems.
I will be. Will be your.
If you're gonna make a joke, you gotta commit. With...
Yeah, we don't edit these things, Will. So whatever you say is what you said.
I've already said enough things to get just me canceled,
and Tim, as he deserves.
As he deserves.
No, another 10 minutes of this fucking thing.
What are we gonna feed her?
Fire.
These LSD lights.
You're just holding a light bulb, sir.
Here's some crystal meth. Please enjoy.
It's a shit ton of crystal meth.
Oh, no. Get the sacred candle out again. She's loose.
Be-doo-be-doo.
Need to waste 9 more minutes on this gaffe.
Are they friends? Like, I don't understand what's happening here.
I believe the fairy is having fun.
I think they're just all high as kites. There is no fairy.
Yeah, they're just that high too. As kites, yeah.
They ate those oyster crackers.
They ate the mushrooms.
And then she set the tent on fire.
What?
She's a giggle leader?
She eats giggles?
I think so.
Okay. Just fade out of this.
Got the good stuff.
Oh, look at that beautiful painted rock. And cliff.
Oh.
A desert.
More biodiversity. We have a dried lake bed.
Yep, dried lake bed.
That must be where Rey rides her magic boat to find the Death Star in a few years.
Or the Space Mormons.
But that was also an ocean. That was an ocean.
Yeah, this is the...
Ooh, acid pools.
I see why they don't leave
California.
Home. Yeah, I mean, this was easy to shoot. I also wouldn't
leave the forest.
We had this set on loan from the Dark Crystal.
Or Star Trek.
I mean, they all film at those same locations. I'm pretty sure Vasquez Rock will show up here soon.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
That child's perpetually sweaty.
Yeah.
And yet, she's the best actor so far.
She definitely holds that flop sweat real well.
She... It's the cocaine.
Like all Star Wars actors, they are all high.
It's the 80s.
Ooh. These lumberjacks are like, fuck it, I'm going to stroll up to the door and knock.
He is our Gimli.
He just throws that axe around a lot.
Gimli's going to bust his way in.
Melon?
By the way, those aren't windows. Those are former bathrooms.
I saw the shit leaking out. That makes sense. Is it the stairs?
Look to the left. Stairs.
I swear there were stairs in that matte painting.
Admission, 5 credits.
The rock!
It's actually a key?
I forget. I tossed that thing in my teenage rebellion. Beat him to death with your spiky club. Just saying, a little sacrificial to the dark gods never hurt.
Listen, I have a secret. I kept your rock, you moron.
Make him eat it. You call him on the phone. It's a phone, bro.
You used to call me on my rock phone.
All right.
It was a magic pocket.
It's for the blood sacrifices.
See, you stab it into your sister.
A life for a life.
The blood will fuel the ritual.
We will sacrifice your 2 life forces for your parents because they are not fucking worthless.
Oh, it's a divining spear tip.
Ooh.
To quote ICP, magnets, how do they work?
Science, bitch. Oh, and well, the rock ran away.
Good thing we have the Swole Ewok.
Good thing we have Tim the Enchanter Ewok.
Nope.
Glad we hold this with one hand and it makes a typewriter sound.
Oh, okay.
Science, I guess.
Yeah. Now we may enter hell.
I do love that that gun is basically just a cheap plastic toy gun.
Oh, 100%. That is a spray-painted Super Soaker.
Again, Axe Ewok is going first.
Yes. He's the bravest. He's the
party paladin, yeah. He's clearly got the higher armor class. He's got the wooden, like, chest plate.
I think that's made of bones.
It is made of... I know, I think it's made of trees. Like,
no, it's 100% wood.
All right.
Yeah. But still...
I like to think it was his victims. Now, that's paper.
That's paper mache. I guess paper mache. Maybe canvas. I'll go canvas rock. I've built canvas rocks. Man, they are sweating like pigs here. Like
they're out in the California desert.
God, well, think about those actors and all those rugs.
Yeah.
Let's put our magic wings on, and surely that will solve the situation.
They can only film in half-hour increments because the actors would have died.
That's why it was only one shot. Oh, she has Sindel with a sus sound. Ugh. These white girl names.
I'm a little disappointed, AMG, we didn't get some wings to put on our Ewok hats.
I'm saying you can 3D leaders. You can green stuff that.
Green stuff that. I can't.
I can. Remember, I made hair for my bald leader commander to make it look like Tim. Although, that blue one seems a lot less decorative than the white one.
Well, it's because it does look like he's on babysitting duty, so...
Ah, that's true, too. Doesn't have to be as fancy. All right, so now that I'm wearing the blue wings of storytelling, it's my turn to talk. Shut up.
Do not fear, listeners. I have returned with more booze.
Oh, excellent. I kind of wonder where Will has gone.
No one noticed you left.
Ben noticed...
Well, I made a comment about modeling minis, and you didn't say anything. So I was like, oh, we must be getting more drinks.
See, this is Shelob. They really are just...
Lord of the Rings all over the place.
Yeah.
I mean, this was the 83 where no one knew really Lord of the Rings existed, so...
Well, there's the Bakshi film,
yeah. They didn't get to this part of the books, though.
Listen, Leonard Nimoy had already produced his... Is a Frodo Baggins album.
Oh no, it's a plastic spider. Well, there it goes.
And like all Star Wars, it fell down an endless chasm.
Which only means it will come back.
It's not dead.
Somehow.
Somehow a spider has returned.
Oh wait, was the other half of that spider somehow become Maul's other half? Like,
yeah.
Somewhere there, top of a spider and the bottom of Maul, just roaming around the woods.
If I ever find myself lost in Star Wars and about to die, I will throw myself down a bottomless chasm. It's got like 100% survival rate.
Did they not bring Wicket? Or Wugget? No. Whatever the brother's name is?
He's too young. He's too young. Is the brother Shodu? I think the brother... There's Deej. No, Deej is the dad.
Deej is the father. Then there's the eldest son with the white wings.
Right.
Or the red wings. I don't know.
I think that may be
Shodu. That's Detroit.
That's Detroit.
Oh, no. That's a bigger puppet with...
That's a big old unmoving plastic spider. Wait, now it's moving. Now it's moving. Yeah, why are we not shooting this thing?
Because he used all of his juice, Blake breaking the rock open.
Throw the gun at it
for dramatic tension. And he is also covered in the medicine from before.
Corn syrup.
Oh, oh no. Here we go.
Oh.
He's been saving his spell slots for this the whole time.
Lasers.
What?
Or no, we're hypnotizing the spider.
Nope. Yes, hypnotizing the spider.
To fling itself into the hole?
I just saw the strings of the model.
Oh, 100%.
Oh, we're casting sleep. Okay.
There we go. I'm real surprised we didn't see Gimli Swolok.
Just about there. Well, you can't huck the axe at it because then it'll be gone.
That's true.
And then how do we know who's who?
Oh, look at those wires on that model. Oh, here we go. Here we go, Swolok.
Spider webs notoriously attached by just one strand.
And bottomless
gun. And bottomless gun.
All right, I need an edit where Spider just falls on the Millennium Falcon. Like, fuck, what was that?
Are we not concerned about how our way back is gone?
Yeah, we'll worry about that when we come back.
That's, I mean, we're probably all going to die anyway.
Where do these stairs even go? The Gorak can't use this entrance.
Yes, maybe Gorak he just jumps.
This is just a root cellar.
Whoa, that kid got way too much of a hand.
Get that hand right up in there.
We got to help Hank.
Oh, God, it fell all the way down into them.
You are in Wicket's hood now.
You can get shanked.
Bitch, this is how you get cut.
All right, I'd pay to see an edit of this where it was Della Reese cutting a man. Oh.
Just like Sam.
Did Peter Jackson steal this scene directly?
Yeah, 100%.
Give it a good smacking.
Just beat the corpse.
Yeah.
You know, a good rope would be handy here.
It's a shame we threw it out of the glider an hour ago.
Starting to blur.
Starting.
And I'm not sure it's a bad thing.
Oh, there's fire.
Who the hell are these people?
It's the druids.
Oh, has it been an inside job the entire time?
Mm-hmm.
I knew it.
It's Max Rebo.
Let me pull out my gun that is clearly out of ammunition from the last scene.
Yeah.
It's a club.
But you know, it'll help me feel safe.
That feels like a big giant mace right there, or shovel.
Oh, look, the bones of my parents.
I am mesmerized by the bone. In femur, we trust.
Well, middle brother's getting,
Sorry, he's got the red wings of courage, and much like Detroit, he'll just choke.
Yeah. All right. We're definitely stealing this from, you know, the Odyssey. It's all fine. It's all fine here.
That's his writing desk. Or for when you just chew on bare bones as a monster, things you do in your spare time.
Yeah, I get to that sweet, sweet marrow, Will. The sweet marrow.
That's right, man. And look at that nipple just sculpted in there.
But he's also wearing a bandolier and a belt.
With very human eyes.
Yeah, why is he keeping these people hostage?
So that they're fresh?
He's a preservationist.
Is he trying to breed
them? We've
all
got that weird ant that cans too much stuff.
Quickly, get him right in the ankles.
Yes, shoot his nipples.
I sure hope we don't defeat him with friendship.
What is just this? In time for our dramatic finale, the half a pint of moonshine is finished.
We have 16 minutes left.
We might make it.
What? Oh. He can right in the eye? Bravo, little Ewok.
Look
Bravo.
At him. That's why he's got the red wings of courage.
Yeah.
You little shits.
He's leading them away. Also, I would have paid to watch an X-Wing just come by and shoot this thing in the head by one point. Chewbacca's an AT-ST going through the forest. This guy shows up.
Yeah, having it beat the shit out of the AT-STs would have been made a little bit more sense.
Someone's riding the Gorax.
Pig face giant Kenner toy wasn't particularly marketable.
Yeah, this does have an ugly design to the 80s feel to it.
Yeah.
We'll simply use the 20-foot-tall axe instead of me and my throwing capabilities.
I love how he just facepalms the kids all the time.
He just poked his eyes.
I mean, it makes sense that Swole Ewok would also go for the giant axe.
Yeah, absolutely.
We'll use leverage to toss you, child. Then you can also be in the cage with the parents.
Here we go. It would also take an Ewok as beefy as a Swole Rock to do this.
I love the panning shot with Hank just standing still there. Is that my son or am I hallucinating?
So far, the only thing Hank has done is mesmerize this spell for sleep.
Your daughter is dead. She was consumed for the cleric's magics.
Also, they can escape out of that thing. That hole is gigantic.
But they're at least 15 feet above the ground. That's deadly. They're all so sweaty.
Oh. What? Meanwhile, his dad does nothing to help him.
Well, glad we climbed through this hole now that we are three of us trapped.
Yeah, glad we're all in the cage now.
What?
Ah.
You had an escape rope the entire time? Oh, no, he took it with him.
Let us all get into the cage so we can consume together.
Watching this Ewok.
Why are they going up?
Watching Swole Rock just scroll right up there. Just with arms and no legs. Just
all arms, yep.
Why are we going down? We just came up.
I think as you needed the weight of Swole Rock to get him down. Like, only one person can hold them this way. Swole Rock was too beefy to be launched up there. That's what it was.
Coming in at 4'1" and 630 pounds.
He's dense. Also, is the pig face monster? Wait, what? He's also sweaty.
Everything is moist.
Everyone's contract. They got paid by condensation.
Oh my god!
Oh, the running basket.
The Roomba was invented.
Was the mouse droid in the films before this?
Well, that's just a basket.
But it turns out Pig Monster was really bad at three-card Monty all along.
By the way, if they'd chosen this moment to kill that Ewok, that would have been amazing.
This isn't but directed by George R. R. Martin.
It is not.
That nipple's just right
It'd
there.
It'd be better if it was. Until the final act. He's just getting sweatier.
That nipple
and
ring
one
does...
shaved nipple.
Yeah. Like, it's the ring
Why
of the
can't
nipple.
We
moisturize, bro. Moisturize.
There's no lotion on Endor.
Well, there is. It's made up what I made the candles out of. Come on down, Swole Walk.
Now we can tie the
rope.
Yeah,
of course.
He's too
he's
thick.
Got too much beef, man.
Is it going to land on his head? Oh shit.
Moral of the story is be like Swole Walk, boys and girls.
Oh, that dad broke his back.
Is now the time when we run? Yes.
Oh, the heroic sacrifice of Swole Walk.
No. And get his toes? Just like the
hit his toesy woesy, send those piggies to market.
This is just like Frodo stabbing the troll in the foot. Use the fairy.
You should have brought your battle ferret. Oh, now we're worried about this.
He's being consumed by the creature, dear. He sacrificed himself so we could get out.
I mean, yeah, where's Mace if Swolwak is the one who's doing this? Wait, the fairy has a name?
Apparently. You have to read the comic book for that, though.
Oh, okay, yeah. That's right, you're right. Oh.
Fell him like a tree.
Oh, those little paper mache walls are coming right down.
And thus the mosh pit was born.
Oh, no.
No one can hope to carry Swolwak. No man is strong enough.
I'm kind of hoping Swolwak falls down into this chasm.
He closed his eyes. That's how you know he's dead.
Yeah, it's true. Because they don't blink. It's an entirely separate head to get eyes open, eyes closed. Oh.
To chop down all those trees.
Not Swolwak.
I've got your nose.
Oh no! Swolwak passed.
Kiss him on the forehead.
Make out!
Why are you holding the axe that way? He gave it to you. You didn't take it from his cold dead
hand. He's distraught.
Oh, he's going to fall down the chasm. Oh, even better.
This tiny hempen rope will surely hold up.
I mean, it kills AT-STs later, so.
This is true.
It did support Swolwak, so it is indestructible.
Yeah, the wood was what failed, not the rope. You know, they do say most deaths occur in the home. Flights of stairs.
Help, I've fallen and I can't get up.
Oh, my pocket rocks.
He didn't fall far enough. That nipple is just right there. Oh, it's also a flashlight?
Oh, that's violent.
Oh, yeah, this is how this ends? I mean...
You've seen this before.
It's been 35 years.
We pierced his cranium.
It's been 35 years and 3 drinks ago.
Oh.
Now he's going over. Laser
beam. See, the producers saw Alien and were like, that was pretty cool. Let's just take that shot.
I've never seen the laser beam just go wobble wobble like that.
He's dead, Jim.
Yes, dead Jim.
Swolwak's sacrifice will never be forgotten.
Deej Nuts is very sad.
No, that was the dad, remember? And our sins.
I thought
it's a
got
Christmas
the...
story, I told you.
Sir, that's the Easter story, sir.
It's a holiday. Jesus.
It's true what they
like
say
every
about
every good
pits.
Boss, he has a second health bar.
And we're going to poke him with a magic walking stick.
Use the candle, tiny child.
All right, King Kong moment. King Kong. Oh, There you go. Axe throwing.
The sacred relic.
Ow. No, that was just the guy's fucking tool.
Oh, yeah, he fell real hard that time.
Which means he'll be back for the sequel.
What?
Once again, bottomless chasms.
We have to Tarzan swing across.
Oh, there's our Yubnub.
I'm just not going to show the rest.
Nope.
Mom and Dad did not sign up to do a swinging stunt.
They did not.
For their one day of shooting.
Putting also tiny actors in full costumes on ropes seems like a bad idea.
Seems like. Is how they lost the other 34 of them.
You're still a little shit, son. Did you fix the ship at least?
Is Arena?
Wiz Arena?
The fairy that commits war crimes. This is just an elaborate setup for how this was her dress that they gave to Leia in Return of the Jedi. That's all this is, a marketing ploy, is to set up that plot point. Where'd the dress come from?
Definitely.
And also to sell a shit ton of Kenner toys.
Oh, absolutely.
Mace with fairy.
But that fairy took like 3D batteries because it's 1984.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Sorry we killed all your family by consuming them in the fire of the magic candle.
No, the magic candle turned her friendly.
Yeah, I mean, I'd be pretty friendly too if I watched someone kill all my friends and family for not cooperating. Drunk Will endorses genocide.
Maybe that's why Tim always does it.
Well, like most films of colonialism, here comes the native dances.
The appropriation of rituals and festive foods.
It's like that scene from Titanic where the Irish are dancing, remember?
Bust it down, Wicket. Do a flip.
Oh.
Here is your ferret.
Trying to get laid tonight.
Your ferret and flowers.
Meanwhile, Deej is like, look at my son. Got the game. Yes, and my
fatherhood.
Son shall go to wife this night.
This is.
Did they just agree to an arranged marriage? Is that what that was?
That's exactly what I think just happened.
No, this is where Wicket learned to seduce female women. Female humans.
This is how he makes it work.
This is where he learned to put the moves on Leia.
I could have done without that shot.
Stop licking your lips at the child.
Oh. Love is the strongest force in the universe. You see, love
Bro
actually
Ives,
is.
You
all
are no Werner Herzog, sir.
God, if this had been narrated by Werner Herzog. That would be amazing.
I like how all the Ewok names either have too many or too few vowels.
Yes. Well, that was a film.
We did it, boys. We made
this. I'm a changed man. Oh, it's trying to get me to watch Battle for Endor immediately.
I mean, that's the next logical conclusion.
Let's just watch it too, fellas.
No, I don't have enough moonshine for that, and I would die.
Keep
going. I'm afraid to stand up out of my chair right now.
I would be very afraid
to
stand
up. The Ewoks continue as Wicket and his friend Sindel, we got rid of Mace, escape the evil marauders. The gruff hermit Noah.
I mean, they could have fought the Marauders if they would have kept Axie Walk alive, but...
And I had to just fuck off and die like that, huh?
Yep.
So... All right, well, my favorite thing is if we end the show in the next 10 minutes, people are going to see an hour 45, two-hour episode and be like, this is a normal episode of the STABcast.
Yeah, are we just going to not tell anyone?
This is just Ben making excuses, Ryan with 7 battle reports... And Will being concise.
As ever, I'm concise and effective.
What? What I'm saying is AMG is leaving money on the table. There's models being made here. There's Goraxes used.
New upgrade packs. Syndulin Mace.
Lot of the, like, this, watching this gives me a new appreciation for the inclusion of the Axe Ewok. I'm just a little mad we didn't get Cleric Ewok and Warrior Ewok and Rogue Ewok that were also on the Caravan of Courage as other heavy weapon options.
This was an amazing D&D game. Listen, that's coming. The Ewok personnel upgrade kit. Four more models. You can add and place it in. It'd be nice.
You get the blue wings of strength, and you get, you know, a mobilized token. Yeah. You hand out a mobilized tokens. You get the white wings of courage. You get inspire. The red wings of courage give you indomitable.
Yeah, listeners, if you've done this, if you've modeled this on your Ewoks, I need pictures. Please,
yeah,
please
send them to us.
SWstabcast@gmail.com. We'll post them to the Instagram for you. Put them up on the Twitters, the X's.
So, guess before we get to the post-credits Marvel tie-in sequel sequence, I'm Ryan Slawoski, reminding you that you should probably not drink a third to a half a pint of moonshine.
Oh, it's me.
Will? That's you. Yeah, that's you, buddy. Yeah. That was you.
I always close. Ryan always opens. You're next.
fuck. All right, good night, everybody.
And that's how it ends. Listen, a little bit of trivia, since Will's trying to figure this out. The Gorax was reintroduced in the current Star Wars canon in the second season episode Traps and Tribulations of the animated web series Star Wars Forces of Destiny.
It was. What? That's true. It was. It was.
Yes. That was a web series, so I never watched it. So, and Traps and Tribulations is clearly a playoff of Star Trek.
Thanks, Ben. Thanks for bringing the vibe down.
I'm Will Heim, reminding you not to watch this film sober.
But Will didn't make it up awake. And I'm Ben Fowler, reminding you that Warwick Davis and the actor who played Mace were given a camera, and they shot a documentary while filming this they released in 2015 on YouTube.
They what?
And if you guys just want a soundbite of Will giggling to send us like your phone ringtone, hit up Ben.
We got you.
I'm the editor now, bitch. I'll make it.
You're the editor for 90% of the episodes right now.
Yeah.
Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Night.
Bam, ba, 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 ba.